Approximately 2 years ago, Ausco Modular went down and started our journey to get our Reconciliation Action Plan, otherwise known as a RAP, endorsed by Reconciliation Australia. We felt at Ausco Modular that it was important to have a RAP and go through the journey because it's about showing not only our employees but also the community and the clients that we work with our commitment towards diversity and inclusion, specifically our commitment towards Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people.
Ausco took that leading hand and said, how can we help? And that's when we started to also talk with Abergary College, where Abergary's also a part of the journey of Boys to Men. And that unique relationship that is now formed, we are seeing now many of our young people that are going through to Abergary and Ausco coming into Abergary and helping.
Look, our kids come here and they have a really authentic experience while they're on site and, you know, learn not only the skills on the job, but also those soft skills of, you know, getting on with other workers, being work safe, the work ethic and all those things that are vital to succeed in a workplace.
I happened to be here in the factory the last time some of the boys from St. Teresa's came through, and I've heard that a few of them are interested in the construction trade, and I've advised them. I said, do it, it's probably the best thing you'll do. And so far I've got seven boys that are interested in the construction trade.
Ausco have been amazing right from the first Garbutt Magpies Cup, which we held 4 years ago. They've been on board every year. It's really important to not only have their financial support, but also their backing for the program and all the other things that are happening around it.
If it wasn't for the likes of Ausco, this program may not have actually been developed to where it is today. It's great to see the support that is actually continuously coming every year. So this program that we have here will continue for a large number of years.
I think the partnership with Ausco is fantastic. And like I said, if the opportunities that they can provide for the kids here today in a number of years when they leave school and they look at the work, I think it'd be great.
Those children have to have elders. And we wanted the Garbutt Magpies to be guides for the children today, to give them a direction, purpose, and to have a sense of enterprise about life. Something is possible.
It's great to see companies like Ausco Modular actually, you know, doing something like a RAP plan. So it's great to see. It's very important, obviously, with local communities, and it's definitely going to help their business grow in the future.
Part of the RAP plan, there's three things that they like to focus on. One is respect, relationships, and opportunities. And this is where Ausco has really embraced all three of them.
It's about making real differences, and that is by creating opportunities. So what we want to do is make sure we speak to the local communities and ask them what it is that they're looking for, as opposed to just assuming we know what it is that they want.
The biggest reward is that seeing opportunities being created in communities where that child had nowhere to go, but for them to come in and say, how can we create pathways for our people that don't have opportunities? And to see a young Aboriginal person to come from that environment, to go through that pathway, and at the end of the day, see them succeed in their own personal journey, that's the hugest satisfaction that anybody can see for that child.
So for those companies that might be interested in starting their own journey down the Reconciliation Action Plan initiatives, it's about us recognising and appreciating and walking together as equals with the traditional owners of this country that we are all part of. So it's about opportunities where we can, and just diversifying your organisation so that you've got a truly great blend of people that can come and be part of your organisation.